In this problem, we're given two masses that are resting on the surface of a smooth incline. So we're not thinking about any friction forces parallel to the surface here. And these masses remain at rest because they're tied together with strings. So there's a string between the two masses, M1 and M2. And then M2 is tied to a rigid support at the top of the incline. So nothing is moving here. And of course, the problem is to find the tensions in these two strings, which we call T1 and T2. So this is one of those problems that's almost entirely about making detailed force diagrams. And then when you get to the calculations, there's not much left to do. So we'll go ahead and start out our force diagrams by putting in the force of gravity. So the weight of each of these masses, of course, is pointing straight down. And the weight of M1 is just M1g. The weight of M2 is M2g. Notice that M1 was drawn qualitatively larger than M2. So I went ahead and made the weight vector longer for that, indicating that it has a larger weight. That's not going to affect whether or not our final solution works, but it's nice to just make things qualitatively consistent. Now the next step is to break that force of gravity, that weight, into its parallel and perpendicular components. So here we're showing a perpendicular to the surface as a dashed line. And notice that the angle of incline for the ramp, theta, is the same as the angle between the vertical and the perpendicular to the ramp. And I made a whole video about decomposing force components on an incline. I'll put a link to that at the top real quick if you're wondering where this result about the angle comes from. So we continue with this force decomposition and look at the perpendicular component of weight. Now that's given by the adjacent side of a right triangle for each of these. So we end up with a cosine function in there. M1g is the hypotenuse. M1g cosine theta is that perpendicular component corresponding to the adjacent side. Again, all the really careful details of this decomposition were covered in that video that I linked at the top. And we actually don't need to worry about the perpendicular component in this problem because all we do with that is use it to determine the size of the normal force from the incline pushing up on each of these masses. So there's our two normal forces, and those both have exactly the same magnitude as the perpendicular component of gravity. So N1 is going to be M1g cosine theta, so that the perpendicular forces balance each other out and the mass doesn't jump off the ramp or sink into the ramp. The same thing is true for N2. It's just equal to M2g cosine theta. So those are kind of there for completeness. The forces we really care about in this problem are those that are parallel to the surface of the incline. So the parallel component of gravity comes next. And that component is found by figuring out this opposite side of the triangle in this vector decomposition. That's M1g sine theta, but then we picked up that opposite side and just moved it to be attached to the mass because it's more intuitive if it's actually just attached to the mass that we're analyzing. So that's an M1g sine theta pulling down the ramp. The component of gravity pulling down the ramp for M2 is similar. That's M2g sine theta. And finally, we can get into the tensions. So if I go back and think about M1, the tension T1 is pulling up the ramp on it. So that gives us another force pulling parallel to the surface on M1. At the same time, T1 is pulling down the ramp on M2 because both ends of the string are going to pull. So that adds a second force pointing down the ramp on M2. Now the final force we need in our diagram is T2 pulling up on M2. And now our force diagram is complete. So we can analyze forces on M1. And technically we're using Newton's second law here. It's just that the acceleration is zero. So really what we're writing down is that Fnet is zero, or all the forces are balanced. So for the analysis of M1, we can just say, oh, all the forces are balanced. So T1 pulling up the ramp has got to be equal in magnitude to M1g sine theta pulling down the ramp. So we've immediately got the tension T1. Now we get into the analysis of M2. And again, the acceleration is zero, so all the forces must be balanced. I have two forces pointing down the ramp and one force pointing up the ramp. The force pointing up the ramp is T2, and that better be equal to the sum of the two forces pulling down the ramp. That's M2g sine theta plus an additional T1. Now all I have to do is plug in the T1 that I got from analyzing M1, and I have an M2g sine theta plus M1g sine theta. And we can do some factoring here. T2 is going to be M1 plus M2 times g sine theta. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.